Hey there, it's Kaylee. Today, we're going to learn about combining like terms. Make sure you know the parts of algebraic expressions. We're going to use vocabulary words from algebra in this lesson. Are you ready? Let's go! So here, I have a funny looking expression that says 4 chocolates plus 3 chocolates. And we need to simplify this expression. So what is this expression really saying? Yeah, it's saying we have 4 chocolates, and that looks like a chocolate plus a chocolate plus a chocolate plus a chocolate. And then we're adding 3 more chocolates, right? That's what 3 chocolates means. So we add chocolate plus chocolate plus chocolate. And now to simplify this, I just add up the chocolates and I can count them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and we get 7 chocolates. Nice, so that makes sense, right? If you have 4 chocolates and I give you 3 more chocolates, you would have 7 chocolates. Great. Now, what if instead of chocolates, I have an expression that looks like 4x plus 3x, and I need to simplify it? Well, if I look at my first term, I have 4x, or 4 times x, which is the same as x plus x plus x plus x, right? And then I'm adding 3x, which is the same as x plus x plus x. So now I just have an addition problem of x's, and I can add them together, and I will get 7x. So what are we really doing here? When we have an expression like 4x plus 3x, we can simplify it by a process called combining like terms. So what is a like term? Well, first of all, do you remember what a term is in algebra? Yeah, it's things in an expression that are separated by addition or subtraction. So in this expression, how many terms do we have? Yeah, we have 2 terms. We have 4x and 3x. Now, how do we know if these terms are like terms? Well, like terms are just terms with the same variables. So do these 2 terms have the same variable? Yes, they both have the variable x. So this means we can combine them. We can think of combining like terms in 2 ways. One way is to identify the like terms in an expression like 4x and 3x and think, what are the coefficients? Remember, a coefficient is a number being multiplied by a variable. So here we have 4 and 3 as our coefficients. And we would combine them, so we would say 4 plus 3, and that will give us 7. And then we just bring down the variable one time. So this would be 7x. But we can also think of it like we thought of the chocolate bars. Remember, if we had 4 chocolate bars, and then I gave you 3 more chocolate bars, you would have a total of 7 chocolate bars. But these chocolate bars could be X's or anything. And if you have 4 of something, like 4 X's, and then I'm giving you 3 more X's, then you would know you would have 7 X's. So both of these ways are correct, and you can think about it either way. Doing it like this, just thinking if you have 4 of something, and then I give you 3 more of something, you'll now have 7 of something, is more of a common sense or maybe a more natural way of thinking about it. So let's do a quick example here to make sure we understand. This one says combine like terms to create an equivalent expression. And the expression it gives us is 15y minus 3y plus 4. But hold up, what is an equivalent expression? An equivalent expression are just expressions that work the same even if they look different. For example, 3 times 2 plus x is equivalent to 6 plus 3x. We just use the distributive property. So let's find an equivalent expression for this one here. Let's start by thinking about our terms. How many terms do we have here? Yeah, I see three because they're separated by subtraction or addition. So we have 15y, 3y, and 4 are our three terms. Now, are these all like terms? No, how come? Like terms have the same variables. What variables do we see here in this expression? Well, I see a y here, and then I see another y here, and in my third term, I don't see any variable. So which of these are like terms? Yeah, our first term here and our second term, because they have the same variable y. So we can combine these two terms. So we can look at our coefficients. I have a coefficient here of 15, and then here I actually have a coefficient of negative 3. I have to include my subtraction sign, my negative sign here in my coefficient. And then if I combine 15 and negative 3, that's the same as 15 minus 3, and that would give me 12. And then I bring my variable down, so I'd have 12y. But remember, I can also think of it in a different way. If you have 15 chocolate bars and I took 3 of your chocolate bars away, how many chocolate bars would you have left? Yeah, you'd have 12 chocolate bars left. So same thing here, we're just using our variable 12y. And then I can't combine 4 as a like term, so I just bring it down and it stays as another term in my expression. So 12y plus 4 is an equivalent expression to this one we started with. Good job. You're getting the hang of it. Do a quick practice on combining like terms on your own to check your understanding. Then we'll do some harder examples together. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey.